We'll discuss about the specific heat capacity of gas. Specific heat of gas is of two types. Now, in case of a gas, we define specific heat in two ways. That in case of a gas, when you heat a gas, its volume will expand or volume will change. Along with the volume, the pressure also changes. So, two things change. So, that means if the change is happening, then that must be in the expense of some energy. So, therefore, to study where the energy is actually going, we have to keep one of the factors constant. We will keep pressure constant and see what is the how much heat is required to raise the temperature of the gas at a constant pressure. If you keep pressure constant, maintain pressure constant and raise the temperature, then how much heat is required in this case per unit rise in temperature. That is called specific heat of the gas at a constant pressure. Similarly, in another situation, you keep the volume of the gas constant and you supply heat, and whatever amount of heat that you are supplying must increase the temperature of the gas. In that condition, by increasing the temperature of the gas by 1 degree centigrade, how much heat you supply, the amount of heat that you supply is called as specific heat of the gas at constant volume. So, there are two types of specific heats. One, specific heat at constant pressure. Second is specific heat at constant volume. Okay, so a gas has two specific heats. One is called Cp, another is called Cv. This is a specific heat at constant pressure. This is called specific heat at constant volume. So, first we will discuss about the specific heat at constant pressure. Okay, how to define this? Now, we have to keep the pressure constant, and we'll do the same thing. We'll take 1 gram of any gas, and you increase the temperature by 1 degree centigrade. Whatever amount of heat that is needed, that is called the specific heat of, or principal specific heat. This is also called principal specific heat. So that is for unit mass of the gas. So it is defined as this is the definition of principal specific heat, small Cp, the amount of heat needed to raise 1 gram of gas by 1 degree centigrade. Now, in the same way, we can define Cv. So, in Cv is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of a gas at by 1 degree centigrade at constant pressure. The increase of pressure in volume. The definition is nearly same. So, principal specific heat of gas at constant volume, here it is defined as the only difference is the constant volume you are heating through 1 degree centigrade. There you are at constant pressure you are heating through 1 degree centigrade. So, that always the mass is unit mass. So, therefore, this is called principal specific heat of the gas. So, we will write the formula for both. Cp will be heat divided by m delta theta at constant pressure. In case of CV heat, volume constant. Okay, so you must remember that this Q is not same in both the cases, because it is heated at a constant pressure condition and this is heated at constant volume condition. So here the heat required will be little less, and here it will be more. The Cp is always greater than Cv in most of the cases. So Cp is here more heat is required in case of heating a gas at constant pressure to increase temperature by 1 degree. When you raise the temperature of a substance or gas, unit mass of a gas through 1 degree by constant volume, by keeping volume constant, the heat required will be little less. So that relation is called Mayer's relation, that is Cp equals to Cv plus R. That means Cp is always greater than Cv by the amount R, which is a universal gas constant that we are not going to discuss here. So the unit for both will be same because the formula is same, but the differ in this heat content here. This Q in this Q, you should not get confused that you should not put the value of this Q as Cp m delta theta here and cancelling and get Cp equals Cv. It is not meaningful. So this heat here is different than the heat that is supplied here for the 1 degree temperature change in this condition and that condition. Okay, so the unit will remain the same. That I write the unit over here. Whether the Cp or Cv, it is the heat required is a joule per kg Kelvin, or so in a heat unit it is like a calorie per gram degree centigrade. Like this unit also can be used. So basically this is a principal specific heat. Now we'll talk about the instead of one unit mass of a gas, 1 gram or 1 kilogram of a gas, if I take 1 mole of a gas, then that is called in a mole of a gas, if the same change in temperature is brought about, that is by changing the temperature by 1 degree, that specific heat will not be called as principal specific heat, that will be called as molar specific heat, because we are using 1 mole of gas. You can use a many number of moles of gas, but then that will divide to get the per mole of gas. So we'll define now Cp, that we denote in a capital letters, capital C, and that Cp and Cv are molar specific heat of gas at constant pressure and constant volume. So let us proceed. Now, molar specific heat of a gas, there are two types, that is called Cp, Cv. The capital C stands for molar. Now, this is molar specific heat of a gas at constant pressure. Here pressure is constant, here volume is constant. That will define the two and see how they are related. Okay. So, molar specific heat of gas are two types, Cp and Cv. Cp is called molar specific heat of a gas at constant pressure. This is at constant pressure. And this is at constant volume. Now, we'll relate Cp, the specific heat at constant, molar specific, to the principal specific heat. And we'll define this first, then we'll relate those two specific heats. Now, molar specific heat means you take a mole of gas and then heat at constant pressure. And heat, keep heating till its temperature increases by 1 degree centigrade. The heat that you have supplied is called molar specific heat of that gas. One mole of a gas. At at constant pressure condition. This is what is known as molar specific heat at constant pressure. Similarly, the specific heat at constant volume is given by everything will remain same, only this will be the change in pressure. In place of pressure, you have got volume. everything will remain the same. So this is under constant volume, this is under constant pressure condition, you increase and raise the temperature by 1 degree. Okay, now here the unit will be something like calorie per mole Kelvin or calorie per mole degree centigrade, something like that. You can write in kilocalorie, kilomole, that you can change. Now how these specific heats are related, that will discuss the relations between CP, molar specific heat, and principal specific heat at constant pressure and also at constant volume. Now CP is what we have seen, that is the heat that is supplied to if I have n moles of gas and I have raised the temperature through delta theta, then obviously to get CP I divide the total number of moles and total rise in temperature, so that will give me per mole per degree rise in temperature. So CP is Q upon this. If I write CP, the principal specific heat, it will have heat, obviously that heat is different from this heat. I'll write Q dash divided by the total mass that I've used divided by the total mass, the total rise in temperature. Okay. Now, I must relate this to relate this molar specific with the principal specific, I must have the relation between the number of moles and the mass of the gas. We know that the number of moles is mass by molar mass. Okay, this is the mass of a given gas. It can be anything that you have taken, and this is fixed for a given gas, that is called molar mass or molecular weight. This is the molecular weight of the gas. So in place of this n, I will write Q divided by mass of the gas divided by molar mass. So molar mass will be here and delta theta is there. So this is your and this can be written as C. This is your CP at constant pressure. This is CP, and this is into M. This is your capital CP. This is small CP. So this way you write the relation that molar specific heat is at constant pressure is equal to molecular weight into principal specific heat at constant pressure. Okay. So this is how they are related. Similarly, if we talk about the CV and small CV, capital CV, the relation will also be this is CV is equal to some heat that you are supplying for n moles and delta theta. Here the heat supplied due to small m delta theta. This is a number of moles can be mass by molar mass will come up. Mass is here. This Q delta theta, this part is replaced by CV into capital M. This is how we write the molar specific heat of the gas at constant volume is molecular weight times the principal specific heat of the gas at constant volume. So this is how they are related. Okay. Now you must take note of this, then we will proceed to the next video. Okay. Thank you.